Hello! Welcome to the Holiday Card Series for 2013. Today is day one, and we're going to jump right into the card. I'm just going to let this video kind of go while I'm talking to you for a minute. I wanted to explain how this year's Holiday Card Series for 2013 is going to go. Like last year, it's going to be Monday, Wednesday, Friday. We're starting on a Wednesday this year, so you'll have a video on Friday, and then the following week it'll be Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and then so on until we hit 25 card videos. So I'm going to try to keep kind of my regular schedule where Wednesdays has some sort of coloring on it. So today's card, I'm going to be coloring with some Copic markers. So anyway, I'm going to jump right into the card here. What I've done is I just scored some Nina Desert Storm cardstock, and I'm using a Lifestyle Crafts embossing folder to emboss some dots on the front of this card. Some nice, really big dots. I thought they were very sort of Christmas looking. And now I'm using the scallop circle stackable dies from Lawn Fawn to cut out a red scallop circle. This cardstock I'm using here is probably one I'm going to be using quite a bit throughout the holiday card series. This is a new color from Basil from their card shop collection. The color is Red Hot, and it's a nice, bright, vibrant red for all of your holiday cards. So now I have the that card base done, all embossed, and I'm using some Hero Arts Memories Unicorn White ink, and I'm just going to kind of rub that lightly across the embossing area. I really want it to accentuate all of those dots and the texture on the front of the card. And I thought I wanted to only have it in one section of the card, but I love the look so much that I decided to go over the entire card front with the ink just to make it really stand out. And then I set the card aside because I knew it was going to have to dry for a little while. So now we have some Copic Expressit Blending card, and I'm using the stamp set from Mama Elephant. This is Cozy Christmas, and I'm going to be stamping the little Santa stamp in some Memento Tuxedo Black ink. If you've been watching my videos for a while, you know that my favorite ink for Copic coloring is Memento Tuxedo Black. I use this ink in particular because it does not smear or smudge once I start coloring with my Copic markers. So I'm just going, I'm stamping that down. The first time I stamped it, it didn't get the bottom edge of his beard. So I stamped it one more time, and that one came out really well. And now I'm going to go into the Copic coloring. And this is really basic coloring, starting with light to medium to dark, and then dark, medium, light. So I'm going to go ahead and speed up the coloring process for you guys, just so it's not a really long video. The colors I use are always on screen, and I will catch you at the very end of the coloring process. Thank you. So now that all the coloring's done, I took some scissors and cut out all the pieces really carefully. I cut out the Santa and the mittens and the little present gift box that I colored. And then I went around with a brush tip marker, just a black brush tip marker. This is a Copic multiliner. And I'm sort of painting the white edge of the cardstock there. That's going to give it a really finished look, and any parts that didn't cut out perfectly, it'll totally hide any of those flaws. Have some green cardstock here. This is another cardstock you'll probably see a lot of during this holiday card series. This is Jelly Bean Green from My Favorite Things. It's a nice kind of muted olivey green. I don't necessarily tend to go for really bright greens for Christmas, so I really love this kind of muted olive green, almost an artichoke olive green color. So I'm stamping the sentiment from that same stamp set in some Versamark ink. And now I'm going to sprinkle on some white embossing powder. This is Hero Art white embossing powder. And then I'll just hit it with my heat tool just until it melts. And then I trimmed that down so that it was a long strip. Now I discovered that I didn't have my greeting stamped far enough away from the left edge for me to really get this on here spaced exactly how I wanted it. So I ended up cutting the little strip in half and using the longer end and gluing it on, or using some foam squares to glue it onto the left of the Santa. So I sort of made my own little banner by piecing those two together because I couldn't get the spacing just right, but it turns out to be okay. So after I cut the little ribbon V-shaped edge on both ends, I took some May Art natural twine and tied a little bow around one end. And then I put some foam squares on the back of that little banner shape and placed it so that the Santa was pretty much centered over that red scallop circle that I cut out earlier. And so at this point, I realized that when I was coloring the Santa, some of the red had kind of seeped into that buckle area. So I went over the buckle on the button with a silver Uniball Signo pen. And then I took my white version of that same pen, is my favorite white pen, Uniball Signo Broad, and I added some dash lines around the circle area of that red scallop circle. Then I put some regular adhesive on the back of that red piece, and then some foam squares on the green banner. This is going to make it so everything lays flat on the front of the card, or not flat, but everything's even. Because if you'll remember, I put the green banner on foam squares, so I want to make sure that I have foam underneath the green still for when it adheres to the front of the card. So I placed that over my embossed and inked background and pressed that down with the foam squares and also the adhesive that's on it, getting that spacing just perfect. And I'm going to go in with my Tombow Mono Multiglue, and I'm going to glue on that present and the mittens that I colored and cut out. This is going to make it look like the Santa is actually holding the present so that his hands are on top. There are a couple other images in that stamp set, like a mug of hot cocoa and a candle, things like that. So you can have Santa or Mrs. Claus holding different items. And I wanted to have him hold a present on this one. So I took some clear Wink of Stella. This is a clear Wink of Stella brush pen. Added some glitter to his hat and his mittens. And then I took a black glitter brush pen, also Wink of Stella, and colored in his boots just to intensify that black color. And I'll pick it up and you guys will be able to see a little bit of that shimmer on his boots, mittens, and hat. There you go. And that finishes the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys on Friday for another video. I have three videos for you guys. The first one is last year's holiday card series day one. The one in the middle is the holiday card series day one from 2011. And then the last one is from 2010. So hope you guys enjoy kind of going down memory lane and exploring those other holiday card series videos. And as usual, if you love this video and you want to see more and you don't want to miss any more of the holiday card series, click that button in the top corner that says subscribe. You'll be notified every time you log into YouTube when I have a new video. You can catch me over at my blog at kaywarnerdesign.com, and you can follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, and Pinterest. As usual, all the supplies are listed down in the video description, and I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.